Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to our channel, Lifestyle Family A&B. Today I'll be showing you a recipe of what to do with all the turkey you have left over after Thanksgiving or Christmas. This is a delicious turkey pot pie, chicken and biscuits style. But if you don't have turkey, you can also make it with chicken. It is just as good. So let's get started. So first of all, let me just say that I am cooking for a large family and that I made two large casserole dishes of turkey pot pie from these ingredients. So if your family is not as large, you should definitely cut this recipe in half. For the vegetables, you can actually use a variety of different vegetables depending on what you have on hand and also what you have left over. I normally use frozen, but I happen to have canned green beans left over, so that's why those are canned in this recipe. And the vegetable stock that this recipe calls for is actually just the boiled water that we're going to cook the vegetables in. We're going to set some of that aside to use as our broth for our pot pie. And if you don't have half and half, you can also use heavy whipping cream. If you don't have any kind of cream, then you can replace some of the vegetable stock with regular whole fat milk. And for the biscuits, I always just use canned biscuits. You can certainly make them homemade, but I find that the canned biscuits perform very well in this recipe and they save me a lot of time. So now all you need to do is take a screenshot of this ingredients list and we're ready to get started. First, we're going to boil 4 quarts of water. I have a 8-quart pot here and I filled it halfway. Add 1 teaspoon of salt to the water. This will give your vegetables a little bit of salty flavor. If you put a top on, it will boil a lot faster and save you time. We're gonna add the carrots first and boil them for about 5 minutes. Next, we're gonna add the potatoes, the corn, and the lima beans. If you don't have lima beans, you can also use frozen peas as well. And now we'll boil them all together for an additional 15 minutes. Next, remove the vegetables and save 5 cups of the hot water as your stock for our broth. Now we're going to fry the celery and the onion in butter. I add a little oil to the pan before adding butter because it prevents the butter from browning too quickly and burning when the pan is hot. Keep cooking the celery and the onions until they're starting to get brown on the edges and they soften up a little bit. Once they're done, you're going to remove them from the pan and set them aside. Try to get out as many bits as possible because we're going to use the pan again to make our roux. To make the roux, you're going to again add a teaspoon of oil and 4 tablespoons of butter. For the roux, you will need a wire whisk if you're using a stainless steel pan. If you're using a nonstick pan, then you will need a nylon whisk. It's very important that you continue whisking once you add the flour. If you don't do this step, you can burn the roux, which will give a bad taste to your broth, or you can overcook it, which will cause it to lose its thickening power, which is the whole point of doing this roux. So we want to dissolve the flour into the butter to make a very smooth paste. This is as dark as you want your roux to get. If it gets much darker than this, then the flour will no longer have any thickening power. The point of this step is to create a thicker broth for your pot pie. And you want to add the stock into it a very little at a time, whisking it really well, making sure there's no lumps. Once you have gotten a certain amount mixed in well, you could start adding more broth at once. I added 1 cup, then I added 2, and then the last step, I think I added 3. So you can start adding more as the broth begins to loosen up. Just make sure you don't have any chunks. Now we're gonna go ahead and add our bouillon, our poultry seasoning, any pepper that you want to include. Now is also time you can add the sage, your half cup of half and half or heavy whipping cream, the parsley, and now you need to whisk everything well and continue simmering it to bring it back up to a boil. Once you see a lot of steam coming out around the edges and bubbles starting to form like in this picture right here, then you know you're ready to go ahead and start adding in all the ingredients to your broth to form your pot pie mixture. And this is not very thick, and that's okay. It doesn't need to be because we're putting biscuits on top, and there's a lot of starch in the flour of the biscuits that is going to get into the broth and thicken it as well. Now we've added our turkey, our green beans, our cooked vegetables, basically just dumping everything in there all at once now to get it mixed together well. Here's where I add the second teaspoon of salt, the first one I used in the broth in the beginning. Now we're going to set the oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. And in this part of the video, I had a little bit of a blooper. I paused here so you can see this knife. This is the kind you want to use. The one I was using did not have a serrated edge. When I started, I was trying to cut these biscuits in half with it, and it just really did not work. As you can see, I was struggling. As soon as I switched to the serrated knife, I had no issue at all. So you want to cut your biscuits in half like this, crosswise, because if you leave them really thick, they're going to be super gooey on the bottom side, and it's not going to be as enjoyable and as good a texture as when you cut them in half. By cutting them in half, you get a really nice toasty top, but not so much gooey underside. So it's just the perfect thickness for these biscuits by cutting them in half. When you pour the mixture into your glass casserole dish, make sure you leave room for the biscuits. As you can see, you need about an inch and a half, and this will help make sure that the mixture doesn't boil over into the bottom of your oven. I cut up biscuits also to just fill in the little gaps at the end. Now you can go ahead and put it in the oven at 375 degrees for about 25 minutes, give or take some. I'm laughing at this part because I put two in and I forgot and took one out before I started recording, so it looks like one disappeared from my oven, but actually I had just already pulled it out beforehand before recording. And here is the final turkey pot pie. So you can see the size of the casserole dishes I made. This was the smaller of the two. It cooked up a little bit browner. The bigger your casserole dish is, the more the less brown it's going to be in the center biscuits, but this one was a little smaller, so they all browned perfectly. But even the other one came out really well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one. See you guys next time.